Hi, I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, board-certified orthopedic surgeon and black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Today, we're going to talk about inflammation and why it's a necessary evil. If you have sustained any type of injury, you have experienced inflammation. The swelling, the pain, the stiffness, the warmth, they're not fun. However, inflammation is incredibly important. Without it, we would not be able to survive. However, like many things in life, there is a balance. If we have too much of it, then we have pain, disability, and it can cause damage to other tissues. As an orthopedic surgeon, we try to limit bad effects of inflammation while harnessing the good. At times, it is a balance that is hard to find. To understand inflammation, you have to understand that our bodies have developed many mechanisms to deal with our harsh surroundings. Bacteria and viruses, saber-toothed tigers, fire, cold, and the list goes on. We have developed ways to protect ourselves. This includes barriers such as skin, the acid in our stomach, or even our skeleton. We can call these innate defenses. On a microscopic level, there are specialized mechanisms, special cells that, when activated, facilitate a response to injury and eventual healing. It is this complex cascade of events that I will focus in on today, called inflammation. Small aside, I'm sure all of us have seen words with the ending of itis. That's inflammation. Arthritis, joint inflammation. Tendonitis, inflammation of a tendon. You get it. It is inevitable that our innate defenses will break down at some point. Some point may be more frequent for others. The first step to healing is inflammation. So let's go through the process a little bit.
And keep in mind, it is a similar process as to whether it is trauma, infection, burns, or anything else that can mess us up.
Our innate defenses have alarm systems or tripwires set up. When these defenses are violated, whether it be a broken bone, a cut, an infection, you get the point. There are immediate events that take place that your body must undergo to prevent further damage and to begin healing. So let's say there's a broken bone. I'm a bone doctor. Not only is the bone broken, but the surrounding tissues are often stretched, pulled, or damaged in some way. Blood vessels are torn, muscle is bruised. Immediately, chemicals that are often parts of injured cells are released by the trauma. We then perceive pain. Special receptors in our peripheral nervous system tell our brain there is something bad going on and efforts need to be made to mitigate the damage. Get away from the fire. Stop walking on your broken foot. These chemicals also cause changes in the immediate area of the trauma, such as causing blood vessels to dilate and making those blood vessels leaky. These changes allow extra blood flow to the area, more fluid enters into the tissues, and it slows the local speed of the blood flow. All of this together results in warmth, redness, and swelling. If this extra fluid collection is occurring around tissues that usually move, such as joints or muscles, then there will be pain with an actual physical block to movement, resulting in stiffness. Additionally, the chemicals released recruit specialized cells, neutrophils, macrophages, that fight off any invading organisms and clear away damaged cells. These specialized cells also start to recruit other cells that will eventually begin rebuilding the tissues. The process often goes from hours to days, but can last weeks depending on the severity of the trauma or other issues. The process stops once the original cause is removed, the damaged tissues are cleared, and new healthy tissues are restored. Pro-inflammatory diseases such as diabetes, poor nutrition, often the two are linked, inhibit the body from its normal inflammatory functions. Clearing damaged tissues, achieving adequate blood flow, and restoring the normal tissues can all be affected. If you want to heal right, you need to control these factors. When recovering from an injury, a doctor may recommend certain modalities to reduce inflammation, such as ice, rest, elevating the injured body part above your heart, compression, and the use of anti-inflammatory medications. As orthopedic surgeons, we are often treating patients with issues that result in inflammation. These issues include broken bones, torn ligaments, cut tendons, or degenerative arthritis. We have the ability to help remove damaged tissues. We can literally cut them out and help the body restore the injured structures, such as bringing torn tissues back together with sutures, stabilizing a fracture of the plate, or restoring smooth gliding surfaces of a joint. In the end, we hope our efforts reduce pain, swelling, and stiffness to reduce inflammation. The end goal, of course, is to restore function. However, keep in mind that surgery itself is trauma, which causes inflammation. We need the body to respond in its normal way to begin the healing process. We need inflammation to happen. What I'm trying to impress upon you is that inflammation is definitely a good thing when there's a reason for it. So while it is not fun, know that it is okay to have it within reason. As always, if you have any concerns, seek out a medical professional. Again, I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, board-certified orthopedic surgeon and black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I hope to help you keep moving.